Welcome dear students in second year computer science class. Today we are going to start chapter number 4, C Fundamentals. And today's topic is C Fundamentals. What is basically C Fundamentals or what we need to know about this chapter? Whenever you start any type of project or you go for any program, then you must know what kind of data or information you can use in making of any program. So there are some rules and regulations, or there are some important points you must know. This chapter is very important because in chapter number 4 you will learn what kind of data we can use in our program and by using which method. So let's start. Constant in C language. Basically there are three constants in C language: numeric constant, character constant and string constant. These are the basic types of constants we use in C language. In numeric constants, integer constants, that is 1, 5, 67, 3, 4, 6, can be any numeric value. When you are using integer constant and you are going to declare integer constant, then you must aware what kind of data I can use. For example, 1, 5, 67, 3, 16, 46, and can be any type of integer data. Then we have a second type of value, floating constant. Floating values are always those values which contains points, figures in points. That is 2.3, 8.45, 6.8, etc. Can be any kind of value, but it is between a floating value which contain a pointing value. Then we have second type, character constant. Character constants are can be a single character or can be any character from A to Z. For example, A, X, G, etc, X, Y, Z, you can use any constant character in your language. Then we have string constant. String constants are basically a value of characters, can be more than one characters. For example, hello, good, or can be another word. You can say a string of characters is can be used in C language. So these are the basically constants in C language. These are very important points and you must go through from book that are in details. Then we have data types in C language. Basically we have two types of data in C language, which is primary data type and secondary data type. Let's see one by one. Primary data type. Now we were discussing in previous slides, there are constant characters. So what kind of constant characters you are using in primary data? For example, name is integer, denoted by int, and format specifier is %d, and it reserves 2 bytes of data in your system or program. That is very important question. Normally examiner may ask define primary data types with name and format specifier and size. So next is float. Floating always in points, denoted by float. We write float when we call variable float, floating variable. In printf we will be using these format specifiers you will learn. For integer we use %d, and for floating values we use %f, and float value reserve 4 bytes of memory in your system. Then we have character char, normally we denote by this value. Then we use format specifier %c, and it reserve 1 byte of data size in your memory. So primary specifiers are integer, float, characters. Then we can denote by integer, float, character, and format specifier we use %d, %f, %c, then file size or memory size. Memory size is 2 byte, 4 byte, and 1 byte. This should be very clear to you. Then secondary data type. Now secondary data type, when we go at advanced level or in C language, then we use pointer, array, string, and structure. These are the secondary types of data in C language. Variables in C language. Basically, what is variable? Why we use variable? Basic definition is a name given to a specific memory location. Variable is used to hold the values. Variables are always used with data types. Variable name can be anything. Now we are using variable integer. Integer can be any name. We have learned what kind of integer value can be. Integer can be a character, integer, or floating value. So we represent with format specifier that can be %d, %c, %f, or we can also assign a value which can be integer a equals to 20. So we use variable, we assign values, and we give the name. That name can be, we can use variable integer x, variable integer y. We can assign value integer x equals to 5, or can be other value we can assign. We will learn in our programs upcoming. Variable inside memory. Now these are the representation of variable. For example, integer number, we have integer num equals to 64, then float value y equals to 5.8, and character ch equals to k, and in below you can see number equals to 67, y equals to 5.8, and ch equals to k. These are the variable inside the memory, how we represent. This is a representation of variables in memory, inside the memory. There are some rules when we declare any variable. The maximum length of variable name is 8 characters, and minimum is 1. Can be 1 to 8 characters. For example, x, xyz, and we can use similar words. Variable name can contain numeric values and underscore. We can also use when we declare variable, we can use underscore to represent. Examples are given: integer number equals to 6. Now this is simple example. Integer num equals to 6, that is can be equal. You can integer xyz equals to 6, integer x equals to 6. You can write anything, depends on you. But you have to write to which you can remember, and you can recall it again and again, or use it again and again. You must use that variable that should be very clear to you and easy to remember. So the best correct examples are num underscore 1, we can use like this. Num 23, this is also correct format, and num underscore 1 is also correct format for declaring a variable. So when you declare variable, you must aware basic about basic rules of how you can declare a variable in language. So these are the rules of declaring variable. Now, header files or prototypes files are there. Basically, header files are the basic structure or basic requirements to write a program in C language. If you don't add or you not including header files in your programs, your output cannot be shown. So C language depends on header files. Now different header files we use in our programs. For example, header files contain the definition of functions which are used in program. Now basic definitions of functions are there. Whatever type of function we are going to use, the basic type, the definition is inside the header file. For example, you are going to add two numbers. When you are going to add two numbers, definitely you need a proper definition why you are going to do C equals to A plus B. So if you are using pointing values, you are making grids, you are making any type of circle on the screen, you are using graphics, then definitely you need header files. Now first header file is include stdio.h. on first line you will write, this is preprocessor directive. Studio STDIO stands for standard input output. STDIO, normally we pronounce STDIO.h. So it is basically standard input output dot h means header file. Then we have second one, printf. Printf is used to print the text message to the output screen. Whatever we write between a printf statement, it will, as it is, print on your output screen. You know C language is case sensitive, but between these two parentheses, whatever you write, it will display as it is. Either you are using a capital word or small word or combination of both capital and small words. That is, now example is here, printf, hello and welcome to the C program. In this statement you may see hello has capital words and all are other the small words. Printf, this is basically the structure of printf you have to remember. Then scanf, the scanf function is used to scan the values. That can be integer num. We are declaring variable integer num, float x, character ch. Then what kind of value we can take from users and what can be scanning value. For example, basically we are saying to user give the value. Scanf %d for integer, and num and is used for the gives the address of num variable's value. So next we have scanf %f and x, the and gives the address. So address of x, then scanf %c, then double quote comma and ch for character. Char we normally denote for character, but in short we write ch means character. Then scanf. Now in all these three examples we are using all characters in separate way. For example, integer num, float x, character x in these three lines, and finally at the last line you may see all three characters we are combining together for input value. Scanf %d %f %c and num and x and ch brace close and semicolon. So this is the basic structure of using scanf function. Then we have another header file, include conio.hv, say we conio.hv normally say. This is console input output, .h means header file. Then we have clear screen to clear the previous output screen. Whenever you will execute your program, run your program, then definitely there is a certain output on your screen. Again you are running same program, then the previous output will be showing on your screen. But if you want to raise this output, whenever you will run, you want to see current output on your screen, then you will use clear screen statement. Then we have getch. Getch normally we use at the end of program to print all characters at the output screen and to hold the output screen. When you will execute your program, run your program, then definitely you want to go through your output, or you want to check your output, then definitely that output should be on your screen. So you use getch for to hold output on your screen. These are the basic definitions you have to remember, and normally all these definitions we use in our every C program. Then dear students, I have assignment for you from same chapter. List 5 keywords and explain their uses in C language. List 5 keywords and explain their uses in C language. These are given in your chapter number 4 book. Chapter number 4. Does C language have a string data type? Now we were discussing data type. Now you have to identify in your book, does C language have a string data type? So you have to find. Then third question, decide what data type you need and write their declaration for program that computes the sum and average of 4 numbers. We were using different variables, integer, float, characters. Now you have to identify if your program will compute sum and average of 4 numbers, what type of variable you will declare or what data type you will use. This is your assignment. You have to submit on given date. Dear students, chapter number 4 is important and complicated little bit to understand. I have tried to give you a very clear view in easy way to understand all these things. These points are in your book. You can go through, and if you have any question you may ask, but you have to go through properly, and then you may ask any type of question. I am there. Thank you so much.